Good morning, July 23rd, 2019. That is today. The Committee on Zoning, Landmarks, and Building Standards is called to order. I do want, for the benefit of my colleagues, to know that these hearings are being streamed via CAN TV over there. So everyone put on their show face, okay? You know, all right? So, we're going to start the meeting today with the items to be deferred. I'll read the page number, the file number, the address, and the reason for deferral, and take a motion at the end for all deferrals. Okay, let's start. Page 4, file number 20062, located at 1200 through 1212 North State Street, has not been before the Plan Commission. Page 4, file number 20054, located at 3703 through 3747 South Rockwell, also has not been before the Plan Commission. Now we're moving to page 6, file number 20058, located at 1400 through 1410 West Randolph Street, again, has not been before the Plan Commission. On page 6, again, file number 20059, located at 1234, that's 1234 through 48, and 301 through 315 North Elizabeth Street, has not been before the Plan Commission. Moving to page 7, file number 20063, located at 401 through 425 North Morgan Street, has not been before the Plan Commission. Again on page 7, file number 20066, located at 1436 through 1450 West Randolph Street, has not been before the Plan Commission. On page 8, file number 20053, located at 1645 through 55 West Fullerton Avenue, has not been before the Plan Commission. On page 9, file number 20064, located at 301 West Huron and 308 West Erie, again, has not been before the Plan Commission. On page 9, file number 20051, located at 3347 through 49 North Southport, per the attorney. Page 9, file number 20065, located at Westbury Avenue, North Halsted Street, North Dayton, West Wellington, North Mildred Avenue, Oakdale Avenue, and North Sheffield, has not been before the Plan Commission. This FYI is in the 44th Ward, and it's Illinois Masonic, being deferred and not been before the Plan Commission. Page 10, file number 20061, located at 4241 North Ravenswood, again, has not been before the Plan Commission. On page 10, file number 20049T1, that's 6001 through 6009 North Lincoln, 3100 through 3120 West Patterson, and 6000 through 6030 North Albany, has been withdrawn by the applicant. Okay, so do I hear a motion to defer these items? Alderman Lopez moves to defer. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and these items are deferred. All right, we also have, okay, let's move on the deferrals. We have some late additions to deferrals, and we'll go to page 2. On page 2, I'm going to read the following ordinances, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5?
Five.
Okay. Five ordinances that at the request of the alderman are being deferred. That's Alderman Maldonado. Let's read the document number. Let me just see. Document, this one?
Yep.
Okay. Okay. 2018-9454, address.
53.
I'm sorry. Let me repeat it. 02018-9453, common address 1713 North Harding Avenue. Then I'll move to document number 0218 9472, common address 1639 North Kimball. Next item, 02018-9450, address, common address 1702 North Monticello Avenue. Next document number, 0218-9504, 1615 through 17 North Monticello Avenue. And then finally, in the 26th Ward, document number 02018-9507, common address 1500 North Monticello Avenue. So, do we have a motion to defer? Moved by Alderman Lopez. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and these items will also be deferred. We ready?
Yep.
Okay.
So now, we have no.
Okay.
We have no one signed. All right. Public comment.
So at this time, we'll now begin the public comment period. Out of respect for everyone's time, speaker is limited to 4 minutes to address all items on the agenda. This will be our only opportunity to address the items on the agenda, and the committee will not conduct separate public comment for each agenda item. We obviously will be taking notes on any of the witnesses and referring to those when that item actually comes up. But if there's anyone wishes public comment, I know there's pink slips need to be submitted. We do not have any. Going once, going twice. Okay, now we'll move to the next part of the agenda then. That concludes the public comment portion of the meeting. Thank you, Nicole. All right, moving on to the addendum to the agenda. We have six large signs over 100 square feet in area, 24 feet above grade. We'll hear them all together, and I will read the ward followed by the address and take a motion at the end. All right. Okay. How many do we have? Okay. Okay. So we have four signs located at 1410 North Museum Campus in the 4th Ward. In the 11th Ward, we have one sign at 647 West Roosevelt Road, and in the 37th Ward at 5525 West Division Street, one sign. Any questions from the committee members? No question. Then I hear that Alderman Moore would like to have a motion to pass on these orders. All those in favor? Aye. And any opposed? Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. And the orders are passed and will be reported out at the July 24th City Council meeting. Now we'll move on to the regular agenda. And we'll go out of order. See Alderman Quinn here. Okay, great. Okay, so we're going to move to page 14. At the request of our attorney, we will acquiesce. And we're gonna go on document number 20042, again on page 14, in the 42nd Ward, ordinance referred on May 29th of 19, common address 300 North Michigan Avenue, change request. A DX16 downtown mixed-use district to a residential business plan development. I know we have some boards. If any of the committee members want to join and take a look on this magnificent mile. Okay, we ready, council?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. For the record, Rich Clowder, DLA Piper, 444 West Lake Street in Chicago. This matter relates to 300 North Michigan Avenue. The applicant is 300 North Michigan LLC. The property is located at 300 North Michigan, and this matter was before the Plan Commission last week, July 18th, where it received a unanimous recommendation for approval. I would ask as a preliminary matter that the transcript from that hearing be incorporated in the record of today's proceeding.
So, Alderman Lopez moves to incorporate the records from the Plan Commission. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? The ayes have it, and the records are now incorporated.
Thank you. The property is currently zoned, as you know, to DX16. The existing underlying zoning will remain DX16, and the applicant is merely seeking approval of a residential business plan development to utilize approximately 9.97 FAR of bonus floor area through the Neighborhood Opportunity Bonus Program. Property is currently 15,797 square feet and is bounded by North Michigan Avenue, East Wacker Place, North McChesney Court, and a four-story building to the north, and is currently occupied by a four-story office and retail building. The proposed project would consist of a 511-foot-tall building with 289 residential units, 280 hotel keys, commercial space, and accessory vehicular parking. The developer and our design team are available and seated next to me to answer any questions you might have. We would ask for this committee's favorable recommendation.
All right. I'm going to ask Alderman Riley if he has... No witnesses, Alderman. You are our witness.
Great. Thank you, Chairman. Colleagues, so this is an exciting project for North Michigan Avenue. Over the years, during my time as the downtown alderman, we've talked about this stretch of Michigan Avenue between Wacker Drive and Randolph Street, specifically the west side of Michigan Avenue, which has underperformed historically when you compare it to other blocks on Michigan Avenue, north of the river and even south. In fact, the situation was so grim about a decade ago, the city, under Mayor Daley, commissioned a ULI charrette to try and figure out what the heck do we do with these dilapidated blocks. And the charrette, of course, recommended spending millions and millions of tax dollars on beautification and lighting efforts, which we, of course, did not do. Instead, we decided to work harder to promote redevelopment of this corridor, and in recent years, we've been quite successful in that. But this is the latest project before us, and I think it presents an exciting opportunity to further reinvigorate these blocks. And I think that its proximity to two adjacent hotels to the west on East Wacker Place, also recent redevelopments, is going to really help lift up this part of the neighborhood. And that's why we did not hear of any community opposition to this plan. And it'll also have a very attractive retail podium. We're finding that successful retail on the first and second floors along this stretch are a breeding success. And this is something we'll want to continue to replicate along these three blocks. And so I look at this as a good opportunity to promote economic development and improve an important corridor that sees literally tens of thousands of visitors every single day. I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Committee members. Alderman Haddon.
Thank you, Chair. Just a question. So I'm looking to see where this is located. It looks like there's an entrance to one of the CTA underground, probably the Red Line. Or I don't know if that's Metra. I'm just looking on kind of the maps here. Wondering if there will be any either improvements or disruptions to the public transit service that's there.
There are no planned improvements and no disruption in service contemplated.
I don't think we're that close to the
no.
Red Line.
No.
And then Metro would be further south.
Right.
Other questions? Alderman Hopkins.
Just a comment as a alderman who shares the magnificent mile with Alderman Riley. I have the northern half. Magnificent is not a word that was typically used to describe Michigan Avenue south of the Chicago River, as Alderman Riley mentioned. It's always puzzled me. Traffic counts and pedestrian counts in that block and sometimes during the day exceed the pedestrian counts in the north part of Michigan Avenue. So it's really low-hanging fruit for economic development. And as Alderman Riley mentioned, there's been studies over the years, there have been attempts to do it. This is a great stride forward in revitalizing the commercial and tax revenue generating potential of that stretch of Michigan Avenue. And I'm in full support of this project, and I commend Alderman Riley for bringing it forward. Thank you.
Other questions? Alderman Riley?
You know, Chairman, I just wanted to also just point out a few of the other success stories along this stretch, which represent tens of millions of dollars in new investment. Rocky Wirtz, of Wirtz Beverage, Wirtz Realty, and the Chicago Blackhawks made a very significant investment, a Class L investment at 300 North, just across the street from 300 North Michigan. And we're seeing great things happening there. And then, of course, The Oxford Capital Group has a new hotel underway next to the Stone Container Building, which itself has made significant retail investments in their property, and across the street from them at 151 North Michigan Avenue, an entirely revitalized retail strip. All of that was dead vacant space over a decade ago. So we're seeing some good things here, and I think this represents the latest of what are good developments along this stretch.
Thank you, Alderman, and congratulations.
Chairman.
Do we have a hotel operator? Because I at Plan Commission, I saw these rooms are pretty small.
They are. We have not. We are in negotiations with a hotel operator at this point, so we're not able to identify who that is.
All right. Any more questions? If not, I would like to hear a motion do pass as revised. A motion by Alderman Lopez. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and it will be item is passed. Good luck on your travel.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Now we're going to go back, I think.
Regular agenda?
What about Alderman Quinn? Is he here yet?
Alderman Quinn is here, a representative.
Okay. Okay, we're moving to page 2. We're going to go to the top of page 2, number 8481 in the 13th Ward, ordinance referred on May 29th of 19. Common address 5842 through 5848 West 63rd Street. This is an aldermanic. Do we have a representative or the alderman here? Quinn? We do not have a representative, therefore we're going to hold. Okay. So, page 3, top of document number or item number 20055T1 in the first ward, ordinance referred on June 12th of 19, common address 1570 through 72 North Milwaukee Avenue, change request B22 neighborhood mixed use district to a C13 neighborhood commercial district. And do we have a substitute? Do we have to wait for that?
Substitute narrative plan?
Okay, we'll get to there. Okay, Counselor.
Thank you. Good morning, Mr. Chairman and members of the committee. For the record, my name is Sarah Barnes, and I'm an attorney with the law offices of Sam Banks. Happy to be here this morning on behalf of the applicant, Yeti Coolers, LLC. Here with me today is their Director of Retail Operations, Doug Schmidt, all the way from Austin, Texas. Before I begin, and as noted, I would like to specify for the record that prior to this hearing, but subsequent to the filing of the application, we did tender to the Department of Planning and Development a set of substitute plans. So I would like those plans, please, recorded into the record here today. The narrative did
hold
the
on a second. Patrick? Supposedly, narrative and plans on this type 1 have been submitted to the department.
Yes.
Good?
Yes.
Okay.
And then the narrative actually did not change. It was just the plans. There were some just design elements, but we did submit the entire package back to the Department of Planning and Development.
Continue.
Thank you. With that, some of you may be familiar with the subject property. It was.
Okay, hold on a second. I'm going to ask Alderman Rabois to accept the substantive narrative and plans for the type 1. So moved. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Substitute narrative and plans are accepted. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Many of you may be familiar with the subject site. It was the former home to a Double Door Music Venue. It is currently improved with a four-story mixed-use building. Grade level of that building is currently vacant due to Double Door leaving the site. The top three floors currently contain a total of 11 dwelling units. This is located in the Wicker Park Historic District. And as a result, as part of this proposal, Yeti and its design team has been working very closely with the Department of Planning and Development's Landmarks Division and have the full support of the Landmarks Permit Review Committee towards this proposal. We are excited to announce that Yeti has has set its sights on this subject site at the grade level in order to establish their first flagship store in the Midwest. They currently operate a flagship store in the South in Austin, as well as out west in Denver, and their most recent acquisition was in Charleston, South Carolina. So this will be the first and only flagship store in the Midwest. Yeti set its sights on Chicago, and in particular this property, because as part of its retail story, it is also likes to set an experience for its retailers and for its patrons. So as part of the retail store, there will be a small stage where it will give where Yeti can hold demonstrations, pop-up art, musical venues. It will also provide training for some of its patrons who want to learn things such as how to tie a knot or how to read a compass when you are navigating through the wilderness. So as part of its retail sales, there is this experimental experience part of the new store. As well, there will be a small cafe located at the front of the store. So again, people can truly come in, engage with each other as part of the shopping experience. We have met with the local alderman, Alderman Daniel Espada, as well as we have vetted this very thoroughly with the Wicker Park Committee, both its Planning and Development Committee, as well as its full membership, and we are happy to report that we have unanimous support from that committee. And as a little bit more history on this, the reason we are here today to seek the zoning change is because the property was downzoned by the previous alderman a little less than 2 years ago. So we are simply bringing the zoning back to what it originally was and bringing the existing building into compliance under the under the current zoning ordinance as well. And towards that same end, aside from some facade renovations, again, that have been approved and reviewed and approved by the Landmarks Commission and the build out of the first floor space, there are no physical changes to this building. It's not being expanded in any way. So with that, we very respectfully request the support of this committee, and as well, Alderman Lespada is here and could speak further to this effect.
Okay. Alderman Spazada. Lespada.
Lespada. So close. We're getting there.
I need my glasses are off. Okay.
That's okay. Yeah, I mean, as was shared by Sarah, this is a site that has a lot of cultural significance in the neighborhood. It also has a bit of a thorny zoning history. I'm glad to be in a space where we are creating a space that feels really mixed use, that feels grounded in community interests. Was really grateful that even before I took office, Sarah and Doug reached out to me, committing themselves to a really transparent community-based process around that. To that end, they met with the Wicker Park Committee, who gave full approval for moving forward with this. Just spoke with Alderwoman Haddon. So my approval is there. I'm just being informed that the planning department has concerns that they wanted to see addressed. Can somebody else speak into that for me?
Yeah, we'll ask the planning department. I think literally my concern, I think, maybe has to do with the downzoning that happened, whatever happened, was it a C or was it a B?
It was C.
So the zoning around there, there's plenty of C to make it pretty consistent?
Exactly.
Okay. Patrick, do you have any?
No. Patrick Murphy. Patrick Murphy. Our concern was just about the new zoning district and the context. Beyond that, I'm not aware of any other problems that we had.
So the context you're saying is pretty compatible.
Yeah,
okay.
It's a little bit of both. There's a lot of B's, there's a lot of C's.
We hope this is going to be a very successful concept.
Yes, likewise.
And it sounds very experiential, which is where where retail is going, and the mixed use is going to be very interesting. So good luck. We have a couple more questions, though.
Okay.
Alderman Haddon.
Here. Maybe just to clarify my question, and this could have been resolved through the substitute plans that you guys submitted. I was just looking at the recommendations from the planning department and saw at least there was this proposed zoning change. The recommendation was not recommended. And I'm wondering, were concerns addressed by the changes that they made?
Well, let me just say, I think what Patrick is saying, he can speak for himself, but the idea was, as the counselor said, there is some C zoning and there is some B3s and such, and it was more of a compatibility issue?
It was two things. So Patrick Murphy with the department. There is a lot of inconsistencies in the zoning districts up and down this stretch of Milwaukee, and the uses that they wanted could be accomplished in a lesser district, but it would entail trips to the Zoning Board of Appeals for special uses. So it was twofold was the reason for our recommendation.
Thank you.
Okay, Alderman Osterman.
Yeah, just a request to the entrepreneur, one, welcome to Chicago. If you can devise a tracking device so that when my daughter loses the water bottle that's pretty expensive, if there's a way I could track that, it could help with sales. So in all honesty, I think you're a great addition to this part of the neighborhood and the city of Chicago, and you have a lot of customers in Chicago, and we welcome you here and support this change.
Great. Alderman Dowell.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. To the applicant, I'm not familiar with Yeti Coolers. If you could take a minute or two just to talk about what this is and your concept in Chicago.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you. So for the record, Doug Schmidt, Director of Retail Operations with Yeti. And so Yeti brand is, there's kind of many important elements to the story. One is that it's a founder-led brand, and it was one of these born out of frustration stories, looking for a better way. At first, it was with coolers that ultimately led to drinkware and then other outdoor gear. And the idea is now we've established one of the premium quality brands that's out there and available, whether it's for an adventure or just for your everyday life. And the concept that we're doing now with retail is that we're building stores that allows you to be immersed into our brand and for that mix of storytelling and retailing to really be there to deliver on that experience for you. So whether it's how the brand was made, how it's tested, and it allows for you to have a trusted experience with the brand, or for us to even educate you on what might best fit your needs and your life. But encourage you to come by and check it out.
So it's like an Apple store for coolers.
Exactly right.
All right.
Store for coolers.
Bye. Thank you.
Good translation. Okay, other questions?
And with, I forgot to mention.
Is that a question or a comment?
I actually just had a follow-up comment. Thank you, Chairman. I just wanted to mention for the record that even before the store is opening, Yeti's already become a very big contributor to the communities. They provided all of the hydration stations for the Windy City Smokeout, which if any of you were there, it was extremely hot in the middle of the black asphalt, and that was quite literally the only cooling water that you could get at the event. And as well, they will be doing the same thing at the Wicker Park Festival. So they have already made kind of a difference in the community.
Right. So if there are no more questions, I'm going to ask for a motion. Oh, motion by Alderman Hopkins. Oh, is that a question?
Just a comment. I do.
Alderman Hopkins.
I wish you well in your retail endeavor, but I saw Poi Dog Pondering there in the 90s, and this just breaks my heart. However, in deference to the almighty aldermanic prerogative, I will suspend my sentimentality and vote aye on this matter.
All right. With that, I'm going to ask for a motion by Alderman Rabojas. All those in favor, vote aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Continue the chair. The ayes have it. Good luck. And what is the number? This location is number what?
So be store number 4 for us.
Okay, well, I think there's 4 other aldermen that would like you to visit.
Let's talk.
We need to pass this with... Okay, so we made the motion to pass with substitute narrative and plans. Good luck, and we look forward to visiting your store.
Thank you. Thanks for the time.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. So moving on page 3. Number 20056 in the second ward, ordinance referred on June 12th of 19. The common address, 1713 North Clybourne. Change request B12 neighborhood shopping district to a C12 neighborhood commercial district. Counselor.
Thank you. Good morning again, Mr. Chairman and members of the committee. Once more for the record, my name is Sarah Barnes, and I'm an attorney with the law offices of Sam Banks. Happy to be here this morning on behalf of the applicant, 1713 North Clybourne, LLC. Here with me today is Kevin Rasko, one of the managing members of that LLC. We are here this morning seeking a zoning change in order to locate and establish a personal service use in the grade level of an existing four-story mixed-use building. Unfortunately, over the last year, the owner of the subject building and the applicant here today has been unable to find a tenant for that grade level space, so it's stayed vacant. He was recently approached by a well-established, reputable massage facility that would like to locate one of their new stores in that grade level space. Unfortunately, under the existing B12 zoning, that is not allowed, even through a special use. So we are here today seeking a zoning change just to permit the proposed use at the existing building. We have met with Alderman Hopkins, who is here today, and could probably speak more to this effect. And we do just respectfully request the support of the committee this morning. Thank you.
Okay. Questions by committee members?
And I have a letter of support from Alderman Hopkins as well.
Okay. Alderman Haddon.
Hi, Chair. So this question's for planning. Same question as before. Thank you for sending out this list, again, by the way, with kind of the recommendations. Just looking to see if there what concerns planning might have had, and looking at the recommendations there on the zoning change, and if that has been changed or updated through conversations.
Patrick Murphy again. Mm-hmm. So the district isn't the issue. It's a consistent zoning district there, so the request would be a difference from that, but it's also then a request that avoids a subsequent trip to the ZBA because of the restriction on the proximity for similar such uses in a B1 district.
Is that correct, Councillor? I thought you mentioned in your narrative.
Exactly,
that,
yeah.
Okay, great. Alderman Hopkins.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We are making some progress along the Clybourne corridor with some of the vacant retail space. We're doing everything possible. This is a relatively minor zoning change that will reflect this new use. I'm in full support of it. I'm not aware of any community opposition. We've received no letters, no emails, no contact whatsoever from the community organization of record in opposition to this. We think it's the right thing to do, and we encourage the successful redevelopment of the storefronts along Clybourne Avenue.
Great. No other questions? So do I have a motion? Alderman Villegas moves do pass. All of those in favor say aye. Any opposed? The ayes have it, and this item is passed.
Thank you so much.
All right. So now we're on page 4 in the middle. Document number 20052-T1 in the 11th Ward, ordinance referred on June 12th of 19. Common address, 3624 South Halsted. Change request, M12 Limited Manufacturing Business Park District to an RT3.5 residential two-flat townhouse and multi-unit district.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman and members of the committee. My name for the record is Thomas S. Moore, and with me today is Mr. Levon. Mr. Levon bought this building, two-flat, for his family, and at closing it came out for the first time that it was a non-conforming in an M district, even though it had been a two-flat for 100 years. And the attorneys at the closing set aside some money to make it conforming, and so that's what we're doing. And we had a community meeting. We have the support of Alderman Thompson, and we'd request your support as well.
So we do have a support letter from Alderman Thompson. Are there questions from committee members? No questions by committee members. Can I have a motion? Motion by Alderman Raboyas moves to pass. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Continue in the chair. The ayes have it, and it's passed.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Top of page 5 in the 21st Ward, item number 20057, common address, 8154 through 56 South Racine and 1206 through 1210 West 82nd Street. Change request, C22 Motor Vehicle Related Commercial District to a B23 Neighborhood Mixed Use District. Counselor.
Good morning, Chairman. Good morning, for the record, Nick Fatikas from the Law Offices of Sam Banks. I'm here on behalf of the applicant and property owner, Gomez Landscaping LLC. The proposed zoning change would allow the owner to convert three struggling retail storefronts to residential units. In total, there'd be 15, so an addition of three to the existing 12. We have worked with Alderman Brookins, and we do have a letter of support on file from the alderman, and I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have about the project.
Questions from committee? Okay, I have a question.
Yes.
The existing has 12 units, and then there, you're changing the ground floor to residential.
So exactly.
A total of 15.
Yes.
Affordability?
So this doesn't trigger the affordable ordinance because the existing 12 units, we're only adding three new units, so there's no affordable component. We're also under the threshold for significant improvement. We're budgeting around $20,000 to $25,000 per unit to make the conversion, so it doesn't trigger the affordable ordinance.
Correct? Is that correct?
Patrick Murphy from Department of Planning. The affordable ordinance is separate from the zoning ordinance. By that interpretation, it does not apply. It doesn't. Okay. It's not looked at as one unified development because the project's coming along subsequent to those original units having been put in place.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, Patrick. Okay. So, other Alderman Haddon.
Thank you, Chair. So again, I am actually excited to see another project. Looking at adding more residential units and commercial spaces. I know there's a lot of interest in that in our ward and in other places in the city. I'm wondering from planning on the recommendation there, just some of the reasoning and if it's just the difference in that space of use.
Patrick.
So first of all, the district allows for outdoor heavy commercial use. There's also a wide variety of other. So there's an inconsistency, let's say, in zoning districts generally up and down that street. And specific to this use, going to this zoning district avoids the trip to the ZBA that would be required for residential use below the second floor.
Alderman?
Do you feel like it should go through a different route?
Well, it's not a matter of whether it should or shouldn't. There is a route that it could go without having to go through a zoning change. This zoning change takes it a different course. One is not any less or more correct or incorrect, but there's a different way to handle it under the zoning district that's there today.
Thank you.
And albeit, as was said, a more expensive route. Okay. All right. Any more questions, committee members? Alderman Dowell? Okay. So hearing no more questions, Alderman Dowell moves to pass. All those in favor? Any opposed? Opinion chair, the ayes have it, and this item is passed.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. All right. Now we're going to the bottom.
In the middle.
Okay. Again, in the 21st Ward, item number 20048T1, ordinance referred 612 of 19, common address 9001 South Halsted Street. Change request, M11 Limited Manufacturing Business Park District to a C21 Motor Vehicle Related Commercial District. Good morning.
Good morning.
Counselor, can you begin?
Good morning, Chairman. Mm-hmm. For the record, Lewis W. Powell III. I'm an attorney with offices at 53 West Jackson, Chicago, Illinois. I'm here today with my immediate right, Ms. Wright. The owner and operator of the property located at 9001 South Halsted. Mr. Chairman, this is a Type 1 map amendment and map application which plans have been prepared and submitted by LAM Architects. Ms. Wright has plans to establish a multimedia event hall, meeting rooms, and a banking facility at this location. The subject site is a 118,306 square foot lot approved with a one-story brick, 16,394-square-foot commercial building with 120 off-street parking spaces. Mr. Chairman, there are no dwelling units on the site, nor are there any other proposals to add any dwelling units. Mr. Chairman, for the record, in order to accomplish this, we have filed application to amend the zoning of this 118,306-square-foot lot from an M1-1 limited manufacturing business park district to that of a C2-1 motor vehicle-related commercial district. Mr. Chairman, to my immediate right, I have the owner, Robin Wright. To her right, our planning person, Queer Mosawar. And in the audience is Chief of Staff Alderman Brookins. If there are any questions of the Alderman staff, he's in the audience.
Okay, we do not have a letter of
support. I have a letter of support from Alderman Brookins. For the record, I have several letters from community organizations. I'd like to submit it.
Great. Could you submit it? And do we have a representative? Did I hear we have a representative?
Mr. Ramos is in the audience.
Do we need, we have all the letters on file. You're comfortable with the testimony? Great. Okay. Do we have questions by committee members? Hearing no questions. Alderman Cardona moves do pass on this item. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and this item is passed. Would you like to say a few words coming down here from 9000 South Halsted?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you all for allowing me to bring this business to the community. It's well needed, and I'm very grateful to stand before you this morning. Thank you so much.
All right. Well, good luck, and get back to work.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
We need your employees and your commitment to the community. Thank you. All right. Bottom of page 5. Item number 20047T1 in the 24th Ward. Ordinance referred on June 12th of 19. Common address 3953 through 57 West Polk Street and 801 South Pulaski Road. Change request, C12 Neighborhood Commercial District and RT4 Residential Two-Flat Townhouse and Multi-Unit District to a C12 Neighborhood Commercial District. We have Counselor. Are you? Well, who is the attorney for this? Okay. Do you want to speak over here then? Okay. Morning, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Good morning. Good morning.
So your name is?
Tommy Wilborn.
Okay.
Yes.
And are you the owner of
this? Yes, I'm the owner of TKVD and also the owner of the building.
Okay. So tell us a little bit about the case.
First of all, I want to say good morning. And thank you for allowing TKVD to come and ask to make a request for my business. My name is Tommy Wilborn. I am the owner of TKVD. The name of our business is Carla's Kitchen of Chicago. And we are one of the applicants that received the Neighborhood Opportunity Grant back in 2018. And our request is to ask for our location to be changed from a residential to a C1-2 commercial district. This will allow TKVD, Carla's Kitchen, to move forward with getting the permits to start the work on the space to open up our restaurant, and the second floor will be utilized for office space use only. We also have spoken with Alderman Scott, and he's in full participation of the zoning change.
Does participation mean support?
Yes, it's support, yes, of the zoning change, yes.
Okay. So my question would be, I know we have a letter of support from Alderman Scott.
Okay.
Okay. The C portion, tell me a little bit why it's a C versus a B.
Alderman?
Hold on. Maybe our department can illuminate that one. Steve Valenziano,
Department of Planning and Development. So a portion of the property is currently zoned C12. a portion is zoned RT4. He has split zoning, so the more restrictive standards are what control. So he needs to just rezone the portion of his property that's zoned RT4 to the remainder of the C12 district. So he's bringing it into compliance.
Because but, half so
he has
of
a split,
it is
he has a split zoning situation on his but, property.
Okay. I can read too. So the question is, what is the surrounding zoning?
It's C12.
Okay, so it's complementary, as some of us would want to know. The C12 is a pretty good zoning for a restaurant.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Spoken from a restaurateur.
Okay, thank you.
All right. So you will be serving liquor?
No liquor, no.
Okay.
No.
For now?
No.
All right, well, we have a letter of support from Alderman Scott, so that's important. That
okay.
Do we have any questions from the committee members other than myself? Alderman Haddon.
Just a comment. Thank you for coming down here. As someone who's just getting used to speaking into these mics myself, I know it's a little intimidating. Just congratulations on the award of the Neighborhood Opportunity Fund grant, and wish you success with your business.
All right. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
So, any more questions? Alderman Rodriguez.
You got it. Good. I'm Alderman Mike Rodriguez, just south of you in the 22nd Ward, and I look forward to visiting your locale when it's up and running.
Okay, thank you.
Great. I'll do. Good luck to you. Hearing no more questions, Alderman Burnett moves to pass. All those in favor? Any opposed? Continuing the chair, the ayes have it, and this item is passed. Good luck to you.
All right, thank you.
Now we're moving to page 8. On the top, item number 20050 in the 29th Ward, ordinance referred on June 12th of 19, common address 5722 West Race Avenue, change request RS3 residential single unit detached house district to an RT4 residential two flat townhouse and multi-unit district. Counselor?
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. My name is Paul Kopak with offices at 6767 North Milwaukee Avenue. I represent the applicant HZ Builders, Inc., Adam Zagozowski. Our request is a zoning change from the RS3 single residential single unit detached housing district to that of an RT4 residential two flat townhome and multi-unit district. The property in question is a 50 by 120 by 150 lot. The purpose is to divide the lot into two 25 by 150 lots to construct a three flat on each of the lots with three parking spaces on each of the lots, and the height of the building will be 24 feet 4 inches. We've met with the alderman. He's in support of the, we do have a letter of support for the residential use of this property.
Great. Any questions by committee members? We do have a letter of support from Alderman Talafaro. Alderman Haddon.
Hello, good afternoon. Just wondering a little bit about the surrounding area, and again, looking at the process and Department of Planning, the zoning administrator, looking at what hesitations from zoning there might be. Is this just a matter of surrounding areas being a little different? Because generally, adding more units seems to be the way we're trying to go.
Patrick Murphy, Department of Planning. So the surrounding area is all RS3. This allows them to split the lot and gives them the MLA to get the unit count they want for the three units and the allowance to build the three units in that district.
Okay. I guess my question's about the recommendation then?
Well, right. So we recommended against it because of the context of the area, both from a built environment and from the zoning standpoint. And I was just explaining what the rezoning would allow for them where it otherwise wouldn't.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, any other questions? If not, Alderman Kappelman moves to pass. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Opinion chair, the ayes have it, and this item is passed. Moving on to the middle of page 8. Document number 20046 in the 30th Ward, ordinance referred on June 12th of 19. Common address, 3208 North Costner Avenue. Change request, a B23 neighborhood mixed-use district to a C13 neighborhood commercial district. Hello? Great.
Good morning.
Morning.
File number 20046. Good morning, members of the committee. My name is Edwin E. Muniz. I am the sole owner of 3208 North Costner Avenue, also known as the Astoria Lounge. I'm here to request a zoning change from a B2-3 to a C1-3 in order that I may continue my tavern business and operate a full-service restaurant with live entertainment within the existing one- and two-story building. There'll be no changes to the existing structure, and I have a letter of support from Alderman Rebois. If you have any questions, I'll gladly answer them.
Great. Before we ask committee members, before we ask Alderman Rebois. Alderman Rebois.
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Muniz is basically bringing this to compliance. I have a letter of service. He's owned this and operated this business for a numerous amount of years, and he's had no complaints, and he runs a good business. So I ask for your favorable support on this matter before you.
Thank you, Alderman. Any questions? Alderman Cardona?
Thank you, Chairman. Across the street is my ward, 31st Ward, and this business has been there for many, many years. It's an institution in the neighborhood, and I support being up to code with the zoning.
Great. Alderman Lopez.
Thank you, Chairman. I actually just have a question. How long has your business been in operation?
I've owned and operated the business for 19 years. And business has been there 65 years, serving the community both as a European club or business and a Latin business.
Uh-huh. And so for 19 years, you've been out of zoning compliance?
Excuse me?
The question was, for 19 years, we're here 19 years later.
Yes.
Because the zoning is a B23, which wouldn't allow the use. So
no, initially it was a C1 zoning.
Correct. Okay.
In 2009, I proposed a condo project to the city, and I rezoned it to a B2-3. And when the condo market fell out, I kept running the business with the existing zoning, so this will bring it into compliance.
Okay, that answers the question.
Right.
Thank you.
Alderman Lopez? No? Good questions? If not, do I have a motion? Alderman Villegas, motions do pass. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Opinion the chair, the ayes have it. Item is passed. And good luck to you for another 19 years. Is that
thank
hopefully.
You.
I hope hopefully, you thank you.
We all have a succession plan, I hope. So?
Yes, there is one.
Okay, great. All right. Top of page 10, item number 20060, T1, in the 46th Ward, ordinance referred on June 12th of 19. Common address, 4420 through 4430, North Sheridan Road. Change request, a B33 community shopping district to a B25 neighborhood mixed use district. Want me to, who's here for 4420 through 4430? Is your attorney here, or do you want to wait a second? Wait, we'll wait a second. Okay, we'll hold that for a second. Now we're going to move to the...
We're going to call their back.
Well, what page? Where are we at?
Top of page 11. Amy.
Sounds like a movie. Amy's back. Where's my... On the deferred agenda, page 11, item number 20043 T1 in the 11th Ward, ordinance referred on May 29th of 19, common address 2373 South Archer Avenue, change request, M22 Light Industry District to a C12 Neighborhood Commercial District. Counselor.
Good morning, Chairman Tunney and members of the Zoning Committee. My name is Amy Degnan. I'm an attorney with Daly & Georges. I'm appearing on behalf of the applicant, Connie's Pizza, Inc., regarding application number 20043-T1. Seeks a type 1 zoning change from M22 Light Industrial to C12 Neighborhood Commercial District. Present with me today is Nick Balestri, the Chief Financial Officer for Connie's Pizza, and Alan Schneider, the Project Architect. The property is at 2373 South Archer Avenue in the 11th Ward. This property is improved with a 15,040 square foot restaurant. The 2,580 square foot addition will allow for a frozen pizza production area. There are approximately 120 vehicular parking spaces at the restaurant. On April 25th, a community meeting was held at Connie's Pizza, and the project obtained community support. The attendees were pleased that the project will include various site improvements. Alderman Thompson was kind enough to provide a letter of support for the zoning change, and I can provide that letter if for some reason
We do have a letter of support.
Mm-hmm. Again, we'd like to thank Alderman Thompson, the Building Department, and the Planning Department for their continued support, and we request the committee's favorable recommendation, and we're available to answer any questions.
Questions from committee members? A household name in the city of Chicago?
Yeah.
My quick question is the current size of the restaurant, is it the lot that's 15,000 square feet? The restaurant itself is that big?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is.
And we're going to add a 3,000 for the frozen.
Yeah, 2,500.
Mm-hmm.
2,500.
Yeah. Foot here and a foot there.
Seven.
Yeah.
All right. No question. No. Alderman Burnett.
Did we bring
samples?
I didn't hear. I have not heard anything. I have not heard anything. Nope, nope, nope. All right.
All these restaurants getting me hungry, man. It's like a restaurant.
You should have brought you some. We apologize.
All right. Any questions? Any more questions or comments? No. Hearing none. Alderman Kappelman moves to pass. All those in favor, say aye. Any opposed? Opinion of the chair. The ayes have it.
Thank you.
And
thank
good
you.
Luck for another.
Appreciate
how many
help.
Years you've been in business?
53.
And how many locations in the Chicagoland area?
Currently only two.
Well, you come north, okay?
All right. Okay.
Outside stuff can...
Give us a call.
Yeah. Thank you. All right. Yeah. Actually, we should talk. We have a site here. Are we ready on the 46th Ward? Okay, great. So, repeating. Document number 20060T1 in the 46th Ward, ordinance referred on June 12th of 19, common address 4420 through 4430 North Sheridan Road. Change request B33 Community Shopping District to a B25 Neighborhood Mixed Use District. Counselor.
Mr. Chairman, members of the committee, my name is Mark Kupiak. I'm an attorney with offices at 77 West Washington. Represent the applicant. I have here today on behalf of the applicant, Jason Von Drachek, seated beside me. And the thrust of this is we've got an existing mixed-use building that currently has five commercial units on the ground floor. More recently, the applicant had some concern about the ability to rent these large commercial units. So the purpose of our zoning change is to change the zoning so that we would be able to, given the MLA requirements, convert these five commercial units into five live-work units. Even though they're live-work, they still count against the MLA, thus the need for the zoning change. I will note this is a transit-served location. Jason has been in contact with the alderman to explain the problem and explain the project and to ask for his support. And he's available if you have any questions.
Questions before we hear from Alderman Kappelman? James?
Thank you, Chairman. This is an incredible development, and it's added a lot of value to the area. But the bottom retail area has just not been leased out. But I think it would just it would be very wise and it would be a wonderful asset to have it as a live-work space area. So I ask my colleagues for their support. Thank you.
Questions for the alderman or the applicant? Hearing none, Alderman Lopez moves to pass. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and this item is passed.
Thank you.
Good luck to you. Are we done with this? Bottom of page 11 in the deferred agenda, item number 20014 in the 12th ward, ordinance referred on April 10th of 19. Common address, 2139 and 2159 West Pershing Road. Change request, M23 Light Industry District to a B23 Neighborhood Mixed Use District and a B23 Neighborhood Mixed Use District to a plan development. Okay. Attorneys. I don't hearing nobody here for this case. We're going to bottom of page 11. Somebody from Applegate, Thorne Thompson. So we'll defer this one. Okay. I need a motion to defer this item.
Move.
Alderman Lopez moves. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? This item is now deferred. All right. All right. Top of page 12. Document number 19934 T1 in the 25th ward, ordinance referred on January 23rd of 19. Common address 2244 West 23rd Place. Change request, RM6 residential multi-unit district to an RM6. What are we doing here? Okay, I'm sorry. So let me repeat. RM6 residential multi-unit district to an RM6 residential multi-unit district. But since it's the T1 and we have a change, we will discuss the change.
Correct.
All right.
Good morning.
So do we need to get a motion to accept the substitute?
Yes.
Alderman Rebollos moves to accept the substitute narrative and plans for the type 1 application. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Hearing none, the ayes have it, and the substitute narrative and plans are before us.
Thank you very much. Good morning. My name is Ximena Castro. I'm an attorney at Acosta Esger, here representing the applicant to my right, Theo Scorte, who is the manager for the applicant. As you mentioned, we are modifying the existing type 1. To give a little bit of background on the property, the subject property measures 6,215 square feet. It's improved with a two-story residential building with 7 dwelling units and 7 parking spaces. And we are amending the existing type 1 to add an additional dwelling unit for a total of 8 dwelling units. And the applicant will seek further relief to seek relief for the additional parking space that's required on site. There will be no change in height. And it's simply just to increase the unit count.
One more unit without parking.
Correct.
Okay.
And we have we spoke to Alderman Byron Situ Lopez's office regarding the zoning change.
Great.
And my understanding is that he supports
it. We'll get there. Okay. Are you finished?
Yes, I am.
Okay. I know we have Alderman Situ Lopez here. Would you like to say a few words and comment on this application?
Yeah, absolutely. So we spoke with the applicant. We understand that the change that they're proposing has the adequate parking space and has for the number of units. So we're recommending the application to move forward.
Questions for the applicant, for the alderman? Hearing none. Alderman Kappelman moves to pass. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and this item is passed.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right, now we're down to the bottom of page 12. Document number 20038 in the 26th ward, ordinance referred on May 29th of 19. Common address, 3619 West Armitage. Change request, B31 Community Shopping District to a B22 Neighborhood Mixed Use District. Yeah. Counselor?
Thank you. Good morning again, Mr. Chairman and members of the committee.
Once more, for the record, my name is Sarah Barnes, and I'm an attorney with the law offices of Sam Banks. Happy to be here this morning on behalf of the applicant, Jeff Myra, seated here to my right. We are here today seeking to rehabilitate and expand the existing one-story building that was once occupied by an auto body shop. Mr. Myra is seeking the zoning change in order to actually establish his own residence at the site wherein he will continue to grow his family. Mr. Myra is currently a resident of the neighborhood. He has lived in the neighborhood with his family for quite some time. And very unfortunately, due to changes in the community, he has been priced out of his own home. So he has found this subject property and is going to rehabilitate it in order to provide a new home for his family, but still stay within the community wherein he's continued to grow them. Part of the proposal does call for a one-story vertical addition above the existing single-story building, and that will provide an additional dwelling unit that Mr. Myra and his family will rent out to other residents of the area. And Mr. Myra and his wife and children will live in the first floor built-out dwelling unit. With that, there will also be a provision of two off-street parking spaces at the site. We have met with Alderman Maldonado, as well as vetted the proposal to Grassroots Illinois, all of whom are in support of the proposal that is before you here today. And with that, I have tendered a letter of support from Alderman Maldonado to the committee, and we would very respectfully request your support of this proposal.
So if you'd like to speak into the mic for a second, just so I'm clear, the existing use is an auto repair facility. That use will be gone away,
yeah.
And now it'll be all residential.
Yeah.
And you've met with the community and the aldermen. And I'm not familiar with this far west on Armitage. Let me ask this. I didn't see it. The department recommendation on this?
There.
Yeah, okay. Okay. Hold on. Could you just identify yourself for the record?
Yeah, my name is Jeff Myra.
Thank you.
Patrick Murphy, Department of Planning. No, the department recommended against it because, A, the context of the zoning that's surrounding the site, and also they could address the residential use below the second floor through the ZBA, of which this avoids.
This is going to be all residential, though. That's right?
Right. So, but in the B3 that they're at today,
they have to have a zoning change, right?
No, that's what I'm saying. They don't need the zoning. They don't need the zoning change to address the residential below the ground floor. From a process standpoint, they could have instead gone to the ZBA instead of going to the B2.
We do require the zoning change for the additional dwelling unit.
Okay, great. Other Alderman Haddon.
Thank you, Chair. I love Google Maps. So this is a question for the applicant and possibly for planning. It appears that there's a similar thing that's been done to a property next to the property that you have, where that looks like it was a commercial space that was converted to residential first floor and second floor. Is that accurate?
Again, identify yourself for the record.
I'm Jeff Myra. I'm not certain, but I believe that's true.
Alderman, I can speak to that effect a little bit. That is actually accurate. That same conversion has been done to the adjacent property. I'm not sure if they effectuated that through a zoning map amendment or not. And then if you scan further on Google Maps, you'll notice that this particular stretch of Armitage is kind of a mishmash of residential uses and mixed uses. So after that and with meeting with the Grassroots Illinois Committee, it was determined that it does fit in the character of the neighborhood.
Thank you.
Thank
Great.
You.
Any other questions? If not, Alderman Dowell moves to pass. All those in favor? Any opposed? Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Good luck to you. All right. We are now top of 13. Okay, we're on the top of page 13, item number 20010 in the 27th Ward, ordinance referred on April 10th of 19, Common address, 1033 through 1057 West Fulton Market, 225 through 233 North Aberdeen Street, and 224 through 232 North Carpenter. Change request, C11 Neighborhood Commercial District and a C35 Commercial Manufacturing District and Employment District to a DX5 Downtown Mixed-Use Development, and then to a business plan development. Good morning, Counselor.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman and members of the Committee on Zoning, Landmarks, and Building Standards. My name is Chris Leach. I'm an attorney with Ackerman LLP with offices located at 71 South Wacker Drive. I'm appearing this morning on behalf of the applicant Silver Queen LLC in connection with a proposed business plan development. The subject property is 25,180 square feet in size and is located in the 27th Ward within the Fulton Randolph Market Historic District on the south side of West Fulton's Market Street between Aberdeen Street on the west and Carpenter Street on the east. Before presenting the details of the proposed development, I would like to inform the committee that the application has received the unanimous recommendation of the Chicago Plan Commission at its meeting held on July 18, 2019. I respectfully request that the reports of the proceeding before the Plan Commission, together with all reports and documents previously transmitted to the Department of Planning and Development, be incorporated and made into part of the record of this proceeding.
Alderman Lopez moves to incorporate the records from the Plan Commission. All those in favor? Any opposed? Hearing none, the ayes have it, and these records are now incorporated.
Thank you very much. The zoning change is to for the applicant to develop the property in two sub-areas. Sub-area A is proposed to be developed with a 12-story hotel building, 147 feet in height, containing approximately 16,000 square feet of retail space on the ground and basement levels, 196 guest rooms, and with a ninth floor terrace, pool and lounge, one loading berth, and 36 bicycle spaces. The sub-area B is proposed to be developed with a six-story office building, 88 feet in height, containing approximately 6,000 square feet of retail space on the ground floor, 24 parking spaces on the basement level, nine of which are tandem spaces, and approximately 43,000 square feet of office space on floors 2 through 6, with terraces on floors 2 through 5, a green roof, and 20 bicycle spaces. The proposed development is also set back from the alley 2 feet in order to effectively widen the alley from 10 feet to 12 feet and is designed to comply with the sustainability development policies, achieving 100 points at implementing a combination of sustainable development menu items. The applicant has set goals of hiring certified minority-owned and women business-owned enterprises at participation levels of 26% and 6%, and 50% hiring of Chicago residents and 5% hiring of within the 27th Ward. The applicant's strategies to achieve these goals include an outreach plan to inform the Minority and Women Trade and Contracting Associations and the Alderman's Office of Contracting Opportunities for MBE and WBE firms, conducting a job fair with the 27th Ward, and joint venturing with minority general contractors to meet their MBE-WBE goals. As stated earlier, the subject property is located within the Fulton Randolph Market Historic District, and as such, the proposed development was reviewed and approved by the Historic Preservation Division of the Department of Planning and Development at its meeting on June 6, 2019. I provided for the committee a copy of the approval letter from the Landmarks Division, and asked that to be incorporated into the record. The proposed development has a total FAR of 8.1 with a base FAR of 5 and a 3.1 Neighborhood Opportunity Fund bonus, with a payment of a total of $1,810,945.60. The development represents a $45 million investment into the West Loop community and will generate approximately 300 construction jobs and approximately 300 permanent jobs when completed. The applicant has conducted several meetings with the Department of Planning and Development, Department of Transportation, and the Mayor's Office with Persons with Disabilities, and the Fire Department. In addition, and in accordance with Alderman Burnett's zoning review procedures, The applicant has met with three separate community groups and has presented the proposed development to a well-attended public community meeting hosted by Alderman Burnett, and has met separately with the condominium building located at 215 North Aberdeen to vet this project with and to obtain the support of Alderman Burnett and the community. On behalf of the applicant, I would like to thank Alderman Burnett for his time that he has devoted to this project, and to thank Noah Safranik of DPD for his hard work on the project as well. This morning we have with me Ross Babel for the applicant and Jim Plunkert of Hartshore Plunkert Architects, the architect for the project. We believe the plan development meets the standards of the Chicago Zoning Code, and we stand ready to answer any questions that you may have, and we ask for your favorable recommendation. Thank you very much.
Questions by committee members? Do we have one? Alderman Riley.
Thank you, Chairman. Just a couple of questions. Just looking at the renderings, it looks like a very attractive proposal before us. But given that it's in the historic district, it's hard to tell from the renderings. I don't have the greatest eyes. Are we talking about brick masonry, or is that stamped concrete for the shorter masonry structure?
It's all laid up hand masonry.
Whoa.
Oh, I'm sorry. My name's Jim Plunkert.
I'm addressing that to the architect, Chairman.
All right.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you. Good morning.
For the record,
Jim Plunkert, Hartshorne Plunkert Architects. Yes, it's all hand-laid masonry, modular brick.
Well, it's going to look beautiful there, and I think the windows also are a great tip of the hat to the historic nature of the surrounding neighborhood, so it certainly helps with context. I understand why you don't need to have parking for this site. There are no residential units. I suspect that most of the visitors to the hotel will be coming via hotel van, taxi cab, ride share. Is that the expectation from your traffic study?
We did have to do a traffic study for CDOT. CDOT did review it and approve the plan. We are a TOD development. We're within 550 feet of the Morgan Street Green Line. We do expect most of our guests would come by Uber or by Lyft or taxi. You're correct.
Very good. Well, obviously, my colleague Alderman Burnett has an awful lot going in his ward, and I'd say it's a really exciting economic success story going on in the West Loop. Do you want to speak to any public improvements that you're making that will benefit the neighborhood? Streetscaping, bump outs, anything to that?
Well, this area is undergoing new streetscape by CDOT. It's in the works right now. We are also, like as I mentioned earlier, we are widening the alley. It's a 10-foot narrow alley right now. We are widening it, but we're setting back our development 2 feet to widen the alley to 12 feet. We are also contributing with our FAR bonus. We're contributing $1.8 million to the Neighborhood Opportunity Fund and redeveloping a surface parking lot as part of the project.
Again, it might be just because your renderings are really pretty, but it looks like you've widened sidewalks and bumped out intersections to shorten pedestrian crossing. Is that not the case, or is that already existing infrastructure?
Well, I would like to take credit for it, Alderman, but we can't. That CDOT is doing the new streetscape plan in the West Loop, and they have already done that. That is CDOT's
plan. That's why it looks so good. Well, great. Well, congratulations, Alderman Burnett. This looks like an exciting project. It's architecturally, I think it's a great fit for the neighborhood, and keep up the great work, Alderman. Thank you, Chairman.
Alderman Burnett.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Alderman, and thank you, Chairman, and members of the committee. So as the councilor said, we did have several community meetings. They met with several community organizations. They compromised and worked with everyone in the area, all of the adjacent neighbors. Everyone's in support of the project. It's a beautiful building. As you know, one of the buildings is the office of the architect. So he's actually tearing down his office and building him another office in place. He's been here for a long time. So we appreciate his commitment to the community. Also, The community is already trying to designate some of the 10% of the Neighborhood Opportunity Fund bonus money toward lights under the L tracks and some stops at the metro stops intersection. They're trying to get some different passing rails or whatever over in that area. So we've been very blessed in this area that there's already infrastructure going on over there. There's a big project we're planning right now that they're still working on. So we're blessed with that happening right now. Now also, this is one, and we're getting ready to meet with the new workforce ordinance. This is one hotel that's being built out of seven more that's coming in this area. And that's why a lot of the hotels were concerned about the some of the things that's happening with some of these ordinances that's being proposed, which on average, each of them will bring about maybe 200, over 200 employees in each building. And also on a construction site, it'll be about 200 employees, over 200 employees doing the construction. So we're very excited about this. This is a good economic development engine for the city of Chicago, and we ask for the committee support on it. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Alderman. Congratulations. Any more questions? Okay. Hearing no more questions, Alderman Riley moves to pass as revised. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Opinion of the chair of the items. Ayes have it, and this item is as revised.
Thank you very much.
I know that Eleanor Gorski was very much involved, I think, with this planning of this.
Yes, Landmark.
And we do have their letter. It will be in the record. Thank you. All right. Now we're moving to the middle of page 13, document number 19999-T1. In the 33rd Ward, ordinance referred on April 10th of 19, common address 3332 West Irving Park Road, and the change request C11 Neighborhood Commercial District to a B23 Neighborhood Mixed Use District. Counselor.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. My name is Paul Kolpak with offices at 6767 North Milwaukee Avenue. I represent the applicant 3332 Irving Park Road LLC, Mr. Tom Nowitzki. It is a type 1 designation. Requesting a zoning change from the C1-1 Neighborhood Commercial District to that of the B2-3 Neighborhood Mixed Use District. Purpose is to construct a new four-story, three-dwelling unit building. The building will consist of approximately 980 feet of commercial space on the first floor. We'll have no basement, three dwelling units above. The height of the building will be 50 feet, and there will be four parking spaces. This project started under Alderman Mell. We did meet with the community groups on this. It was a site of a private club, which was a burden to the ward. My client purchased it. We met with the community groups. They were in support. Alderman Rodriguez Sanchez then reached out to the community group, and they affirmed their support for this project. And we do have a letter in the file.
And we do have a letter from Alderman Rodriguez Sanchez on file. Questions from committee members? Hearing no questions, Alderman Kappelman moves to pass. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed?
Thank you for your consideration.
Chair's ayes have it, and this item is passed. Okay. All right. Bottom of page 13. Item number 19993-T1 in the 35th Ward, ordinance referred on January 25th of 17. Common address 3201 West Belmont, change request C11 Neighborhood Commercial District to a B23 Neighborhood Mixed Use District. Counselor.
Thank you again for the record. Nick Fatikas from the Law Offices of Sam Banks. I'm here on behalf of the owner and applicant, Tullamore Management LLC. Here with me is Mr. John Downs, the managing member of the LLC. We have worked for over 2 years with Alderman Rosa's office on this project. We are asking and have support to move forward from the Alderman on a B2-2 zoning designation for a proposed three-story, seven-unit residential buildings. So we would ask the committee to amend the application, the type 1 application, from a B2-3 to a B2-2. Oh, substitute plans, narrative, and ordinance.
So, Alderman Rabouillas moves to accept the substitute narrative and plans for the type 1 application. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? The ayes have it, and the substitute narrative and plans are accepted. And Alderman Rabouillas moves to accept the substitute ordinance. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? The ayes have it. Substitute is accepted. So this substitute is now, we're down to a B.
2-2.
2-2.
Correct. For, again, a three-story, seven residential unit building.
Great. Okay. Continue.
We've worked, again, for almost a little bit over 2 years with Alderman Rosa's office on this project, and there should be a letter of support already on file. I do have a copy otherwise, and we'd be happy to answer any questions you might have about the proposal.
And it's a TOD?
So it started as a TOD. We've revised, and part of the amended plan is to do seven parking spaces on site to support the seven proposed residential units.
Okay, so there will be seven parking spaces.
Seven spaces on site, yes.
Okay, and how close is it to the, is a blue line over there?
So there's a blue line station at Belmont, and we were definitely within range. We started our conversations with the transit-oriented development project, but I think neighbors, without speaking for the neighbors, we believe neighbors had concerns about parking in the immediate area, traffic congestion, so the solution was to provide on-site parking, and we're willing to do that.
Questions for committee members? Hearing no questions, Alderman Kappelman moves to pass with the substitute narrative and plans and as amended. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it, and this will be passed with all these modifications.
Thank you, sir.
Patience is a virtue.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Thank all you right. again.
I hope we didn't keep you too long today.
Yeah,
okay.
I'll be back.
Okay, bottom of page 14, item number 20012T1 in the 47th Ward, ordinance referred on April 10th of 19. Common address 4729 North Winchester Avenue. Change request RS3 single unit district to an RM5 residential multi-unit district. We have the same attorney and the same applicant.
I know. Coincidence.
It is a coincidence, actually. All right. Let's start.
Yes, sir.
Counselor.
Good morning. And for the last time, for the record, my name is Sarah Barnes, and I'm an attorney with the law offices of Sam Banks. I'm happy to be here this morning on behalf of the applicant, Telemore Development LLC. Here with me today on behalf of the applicant is Mr. Johnny Downs, the managing member of the applicant LLC. Before I begin, Mr. Chairman, I would like to note for the record that prior to this proceeding, but subsequent to the filing of the application, we did tender to the Department of Planning and Development a corrected substitute ordinance. We realized that there was a typographical error in the ordinance that was originally submitted with the application. However, the public notice, the face of the application, all contained the correct designation. So we would ask that that substitute ordinance be read into the record here today.
Okay. All right. So Alderman Rabouillas moves to accept the substitute ordinance. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Hearing none, the ayes have it, and the substitute is before us.
Thank you so much. We are here this morning with regard to the property generally located at 4729 North Winchester. This piece of property is situated at the end of a cul-de-sac, and it's actually a little bit unique because it is situated between a very large four-story elementary school and a very large multi-unit apartment building that's over six stories and contains over 100 dwelling units. So in order to redevelop the subject property, We do seek the zoning change that will allow us to fit more in character with the existing improvements in the neighborhood. So with that, the applicant is seeking to redevelop the property with a new four-story, eight-unit residential building. There will be off-street parking for a total of 9 units, so they'll have a guest parking spot at the site as well. We have vetted the proposal with Alderman Martin, as well as his 47th Ward Zoning Advisory Committee and the Ravenswood Neighbors Association. Based on the feedback that we received during those meetings, there were some concerns regarding permeability and rainwater runoff. So as a result of that, we have executed a restrictive covenant wherein Mr. Downs has agreed to utilize permeable materials both for the driveway as well as a green roof for the new building. And with those considerations, we do have a letter of support from Alderman Martin, as well as a letter of support from the Ravenswood Neighbors Association.
Thank
We'd be
you,
happy
Counselor.
To answer any questions.
Great. Any questions on this application? Can I have a motion by Alderman Cardona to move do pass? All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Opinion chair, the ayes have it, and the item is passed.
Thank you so much.
As amended.
Pardon. Thank you.
Okay. Good luck to you, sir. And permeable pavers, with covenant or not, I know where this is at, okay? All right. Okay. Matter of housekeeping, we started off on page 2 on application number 8481. This is Aldermanic in the 13th Ward, common address 5842 through 5848 West 63rd. Here we don't have a representative or the alderman, so we're deferring this item. Do I have a motion to defer this item? Alderman Kaplan moves to defer. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? So hearing none, this item is deferred. For a motion to adjourn?
Yes, motion.
Okay.
Cool.
You good? Okay, great. Alderman Riley moves to adjourn. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed. This meeting is adjourned. Thank you for your attendance and your patience. Thank you, department. Always a pleasure.